we had guests in Armenia who are coming again from Prime, and this is not the first visit of the tutors coming from Prime, but our guests, they are the first time in Armenia, and I would like to introduce them to you. Here we have three doctors. They are not only GPs, but they are also tutors in Prime, and they are very well experienced Christians as well, and had been teaching many, many GPs during their practices. So I would like themselves to introduce to you.
Hello, I'm Peter Lefevre. I'm a GP from England, and I've been a GP all of my life, and have been a Christian since the beginning of my adult life. The work that I've done has been both in the UK and in other countries, and I've had quite a lot of experience of working in North Africa also. My connection with Prime started 2 years ago, and since that time I've been able to help being a tutor at Prime seminars in different countries, and most especially in India. This is my first visit to Armenia, where it's a real pleasure and delight and a privilege to be able to meet my Armenian colleagues, and I hope to share some of my knowledge and experience of family medicine with them. One of the most important features of family medicine is that very many of its principles are aligned to our Christian faith. Family medicine is based on the fact that every person matters, that every individual, a person, has a story to tell and a life to lead, and that they are all equally important in the eyes of God. And so it's really important for us as Christian family doctors to recognize that every one of our patients is as important to us as every other one. Also in family medicine, we're concerned that patients have what is their right and what they deserve. So there is a very strong sense of justice in family medicine. And this again is one of the experiences that Christ has taught us, that one of the features of being a Christian is to ensure that there is justice amongst people. It's been a real privilege to be here in Armenia, to be able to discuss some of the issues that we face in our practice in the UK, and as doctors face here in Armenia, to discuss some of the pleasures and some of the problems, some of the joys, but also some of the difficult issues. The issues that we face not just because we are doctors, but also because we are Christians. And we have prayed hard for this time together, this seminar, and during these last few days, we felt a strong sense of God's presence here with us, responding to our prayers, and helping us to come together as groups of doctors who do not share the same language or the same culture or the same medical situation. But we all share the same God and we worship the same Lord, and it is in our Christian faith that we truly can come together as professionals and share our experience of medicine and also our experience of God at work in each of our lives. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Peter, and we have other guests as well, Dr. Sarah and Simon.
Hello, my name is Sarah Montgomery. I've also come with Prime from the UK. I've been a family doctor in England for over 30 years, and I went into medicine because of a deep sense of calling, partly encouraged by my observation of my own father's practice, who was a Christian and a family doctor himself. I've always been much more interested in people than in illnesses, but as a family doctor, it is our duty and our privilege to integrate both. I've always striven to be an excellent clinician as well as somebody who tries to relate to patients. And that is why I chose family practice and not another branch of medicine. Because as a family doctor, we have the privilege and the honor to be deeply involved in our patients' lives. And we understand what worries them, what troubles them, and we walk with them through the pilgrimage of their lives. And this teaches us a lot about human nature and about how God works in their lives. We see God at work. And when we are with a patient, often when they are deeply suffering, we can feel the Holy Spirit present alongside us and guiding us in what to say. So even when we are with a patient towards the end of their lives, there may not be very much that we can do to heal them. We can always be alongside them and touch them with the Spirit. It's been a great honor and a privilege to come here to Armenia and to have these 3 days to teach our Armenian colleagues and to share something of their lives and experience. Armenian hospitality is famous throughout the world, but until you've experienced it, you don't really know the full extent of it. And our colleagues here have shared their lives very generously. And we've learned a lot about them and their families, and a great deal about delicious Armenian food as well. Every time I come and do some teaching, I find that I learn a great deal. And when I return to the UK to my own practice, I try to put into practice some of the things that I've been learning through teaching and listening to other people. So we never stop learning as doctors and as professionals. Medicine is, it is impossible to become really arrogant as a doctor, because there are always things that we don't understand. There are always gaps in our knowledge. There are always things that we find difficult. And that is why I am so overjoyed to be able to have these opportunities to come and learn through teaching. Thank you.
We really had very nice topics, and we found that our doctors, they shared whatever they had, and audience also was very much interested, because the presentation, the way we had been taught, it was totally different. It was not just a lecture. It was sharing the practice. It was also sharing the ideas and encouraging people to share what they have in their mind. And this really helps us to use the skills and whatever we heard here in our practice and be more able to help people in the best way.
I'm Simon Ramsbotham, and I'm also a general practitioner, a family doctor. Became a Christian at medical school when I was 18. And I've been in my practice in Thornton Heath, which is a very urban suburb of London, for about 33 years. One of the things that you've just heard from Sarah is that we walk with our patients. And general practice, more than any other specialty, allows us not just to give medicines, make diagnoses, but you live your life alongside your patients. And my patients become my friends, and I share in their experiences. And sometimes a patient will say, not thank you for treating me, but simply, thank you for walking with me. Just as Jesus walked on the earth, he walked with us. So he wants us, by the power of the Holy Spirit, to love our patients and to walk with our patients. And if somebody said to me, what's the most important thing for a doctor? I would say, love your patient as yourself. My involvement with Prime has been, again, over the last 2 or 3 years. As I'm coming now towards the end of my professional life in the National Health Service in Britain, I have obviously accumulated a lot of experience, as any doctor does, because of the years. How sad if my work just ended there with retirement. But how wonderful that there's these wonderful opportunities to go to other countries as guests, experience such generous hospitality as we have, and to share our experiences with other doctors in other places. And we've done just that here, with actually seeing patients and giving talks. And we are bowled over by the warmth of the hospitality here. And we hope that this can that we can continue to share our experiences. Thank you.
Really, it is a privilege for us to have this type of doctors here, people who are willing to work with us, even if they are tired. This is the first time that ACMA's students, they're really willing to work from morning even till night. And this comes because of this atmosphere created by you, and because really we learned so many things that people could learn only in the universities during 3 or 5 years. But really, we learned many things. God bless you. You are gifts for us, and we hope this will not be the last time. And let God be glorified in everything, whatever we do, and let whatever we learned be used for the benefits of our people. God bless you, Peter. God bless you, Sarah. God bless you, Samuel.